Mary Quant is probably best known as the fashion designer who really started the whole of swinging London. She helped to design the miniskirt. She always wore short skirts herself, and they went shorter and shorter. She also designed hot pants, which of course were completely shocking at the time. So the swinging 60s was the most marvellous time of opportunity, optimism, and shaking off the old post-war austerity. I worked for Mary, both directly and indirectly, over a period of about 14 years. It was always vibrant, exciting, and always looking for new ways of promoting Mary herself as a personality, and of course, all the garments, the accessories, and other merchandise in which she was designing. Mary left Goldsmiths College and became an apprentice to a couturier milliner, and she found herself making hats for customers who would really only probably wear them once or twice. They went to Ascot or somewhere like that. And she thought, this is completely wrong. I think fashion ought to be for everybody. So she opened Bazaar in the King's Road in 1955, started buying in all sorts of different types of garments and merchandise, and then she found that she couldn't really discover what she wanted to wear, so she started making things herself, which she sold in Bazaar, and they just walked off the rails. They were so successful. She went on to develop Ginger Group, which was her ready-to-wear range. And of course, she also signed a very important licensing agreement with Butterick Paper Patterns, which enabled young girls who were still learning sewing at school in those days to go out and buy their favourite fabrics and make their own Mary Quant clothes. And so fashion truly became for everybody. I think that coming to this exhibition demonstrates just how appealing the garments that she designed as early as the late 50s, and they appeal to all age groups, even now. People of my generation have all those wonderful memories of wearing them to certain occasions when they might have met their future husband or been running, dancing, jumping on a bus wearing them. And the younger generation of today, I've heard them saying, oh, I'd love to wear that now, because they are equally appealing. So they've become timeless. It is the most tremendously colourful, exciting, and joyous representation of Mary's achievements over that 20 years. Mary is the most endearing person. She was quite shy and diffident, but she had a steely certainty underneath of what she wanted. And she was very persuasive. She'd often say to the men in grey suits when they said to her, Mary, that's impossible, you can't do that. And she'd say, I'm sure you'll find a way. And of course they did. She believed in integrity, in doing what she felt was right, and it was obvious to all of us that somebody who had that inner strength could sweep us all with her. And it was tremendously empowering and very endearing, because Mary herself was such an appreciative and charismatic personality.